Team's really excited about playing this Saturday against Albany. Obviously, you know, our homecoming, expecting a lot of Tribe supporters here. Another conference game, an opponent we played in 2019, a very good football team, even though the record doesn't indicate it, their combined record of the teams they play is like 14-3. And so they played some really good football teams. But, you know, we're excited about playing and having a chance to, control our own efforts and destiny when it comes to the CAA. Another phenomenal team that's coming. And we're ready for the challenge. So we look forward to it. And I'll be happy to answer any questions. Lachlan is a veteran player, and he handled it great. I mean, sometimes in the game plan, you have things that you put in, for the tight end or based on the coverages that teams play. He's been really good in his on the line blocking, and that's critical. You know, we've improved our rush game. And it's important that a tight end be able to handle the outside backer or down lineman, be able to do those types of things to capture the edge. And then, some of the routes that he runs are some routes that are designed to, pull the safeties, away. And we've made other opportunities to throw the ball to other receivers. And so the particular game, Elon, he was able to, stay on the hash and go vertical. And also, Darius did a good job of recognizing if the primary receiver wasn't open, then here comes a crossing route by the tight end. He's open, throw it to him. So I think things have worked out, for him in terms of him not complaining about how many catches I'm getting. He does a yeoman's job of just saying, hey, listen, I'm the tight end. I'll block, I'll catch, I'll be off the line, on the line. He's involved in our special teams. And so he's done a tremendous job and truly what kind of epitomizes a guy that just says, I just want to win. And he's demonstrated that. I would say that Malachi is very close to being involved in this game plan for this week. And so it's always great to see some of your best players. And in this instance, one of our fastest players to be involved in game planning. And he's practicing. The week off helped a lot. And so we look forward to utilizing a skill set that he has that can help us, can help us on the field. Yeah, Marty, that's a great point. We have been without, several. We have starters, key starters. Guys have missed games, and here we are, getting ready to get into the fifth game, and guys haven't had the full complement of playing in the majority of those games. But it just goes to speak to, kind of like we talked about before, the next man up mentality and the next guy who wants to go in or the next guy we're going to have to rely on to be productive and efficient for us. And so that's kind of what this team has been about. It's been really neat to watch as a guy goes down, whether it's during the game or we know that during the preparation for the week coming up that, we're not going to have a particular person's, services. So the next two guys up or what else are we going to do? The coaches have done a great job in game planning and calling the plays to kind of capture the skill set of those guys that are going to be involved in that particular play. So I could be more pleased with the team effort, particularly offensively, but there's always something going on. We know every team has injuries. Every team is going through issues, but we've had our lion's share of guys missing games and being limited because of their injuries. But at the same time, guys have stepped up and we found a way to find a way to win. It's hard to win football games. We found a way to win and we want to keep that going. Yeah. Marty, I mentioned that he's very mature for a freshman quarterback. I was joking him because he had the Eminem hair dye, have red hair. I don't know whatever it was, but he let it grow out. So now he's got his regular hair color back. And even trying to joke him about that, he just kind of cracked a smile and just went on being about, just as bland as can be, but he never lets the highs get him too high or the lows too low. He has a skill set that, he's a left-handed guy that can throw, that can use his legs. We've seen him been able to pull the ball down and run for distance. Pretty elusive. So, he's learning the game. it's one of those things you had to hurry up and learn the game because of Hollis's physical health. But Hollis had to learn the game. You know, he started out as a true freshman and played in college football games. So, you know, Darius has a learning curve when you're a first year player, but at the same time, he has an acumen an aptitude to want to get it right and want to be, you know, a good player. And so, we get Hollis and Darius Chase Hart, you know, those guys are always in the meeting room or always trying to find out ways they can get better to make the team better. And so as they get better, then our teams will get better. Yeah, without a doubt, Jay. As I said before, I believe when you look at the teams that they've played, their combined record is 14-3. So there are good football teams that they play. I believe all three teams, all FCS teams they play, there are in the FCS top 20, top 25. So you can't look at a record and say, oh, they're not any good. This is a good football team. They're as athletic up front, probably the best, you know, outside of the FBS opponent we played, probably the best athletic group of guys that can get after it. 96, 8, 0, number 9. Those guys up front, they get after pretty good. You look on the other side of the ball, obviously you have their quarterback that's been, you know, up for the FCS Player of the Year award, and also their running back, Mofor. I mean, he's a dynamic runner and a dynamic player. So they have the tools. And, I've heard, Coach Greg, their head coach talk about, just extending drives, third down opportunities, making plays, hats in the right gap. So it's not from a skill set disadvantage. I mean, there are things that, they do better than they got a chance to win games. And so we just want to make sure we take care of ourselves and their first opportunity to win a game is not presented here in Williamsburg on Saturday. Just want to take care of ourselves, get some players back. Just know the who and the what for them. Because as I said, their quarterback is a dynamic player, and that runner, Mofor, is an excellent runner. So we got our work cut out for us. But, here we are in the schedule that says, hey, listen, this is a good football team we're playing. We played them in 2019. They scored 17 points in the fourth quarter, just all those things like that. So you can't rest on your laurels. This is the goal, to try to go 1-0 right now. Homecoming, home game, those things are important. And so we'll concentrate on those. I mean, well, first you recognize the obvious. I mean, it's homecoming. They know that. Their parents are coming in town. You got football alumni coming in town. We hope that I've heard it's going to be a tremendous crowd. We hope that it's sold out, standing room only, all those things. We can't control the elements that has, but we can control what we do on the field and how we respond, how we react, how we block, how we tackle, how we execute. So we can do those things. And, inherently a homecoming game brings all the different distractions that come with it. But, you try to separate your team from the fact that, listen, what we need to do is take care of ourselves, play our game, limit the penalties, explosive plays we've gotten better at, the third downs we've gotten better at. We need to continue those things if we're going to continue to be a football team that can compete as we start moving this season forward.